Cyrus, nothing interesting has happened.
So are you saying that there are no stories? Then why are we here? Why are we wasting time in the office? Why have an office? Why don't we just shut shop? If there are no cricketing stories left in the world, we should just all go home, do something else with our lives. You become a ballerina. I'll do synchronized swimming. Eat this!
Cyrus Brocha and the team of ESPN Crick Info experts bring you Run Order. It's not just cricket.
Okay, what's our topic?
Topic is with several new countries trying pink ball tests, yeah. Day-night tests, should India also join the countries that are hosting pink ball tests?
Right, in case you've missed it, given like many others, you find your commitment to traditional test cricket slightly questioned, here's the brief history to day-night or pink ball tests so far. Australia have played 3, all at home, including the first ever pink ball test, which was against New Zealand at Adelaide in November 2015. They're also set to host the first ever Ashes day-night test next month. Pakistan have featured in 3 as well, 2 in the UAE, including most recently against Sri Lanka and against Australia at the Gabba. The Windies have played in 2, and New Zealand, South Africa, England and Sri Lanka in 1 apiece. Which leaves only India among the top 8 ranked test sides to yet feature in a revolutionary pink ball test match. In spite of having played 21 matches since that inaugural day-night test in November 2015, including 14 at home. And even in the current home season, none of the upcoming tests against Sri Lanka will be played with the pink ball. Now, 2 editions of the Duleep Trophy have been played with the pink ball, but that's pretty much the top and tail of it. So what ails India and its use of that pretty pink ball for a day-night test? Let's find out from the Run Order lot.
I thought we were going to go one show without talking about the pink ball.
Yeah.
No, but considering that they are going to experiment with...
I think it wouldn't have been the worst idea. I'm not a big fan of it in India because just talking to guys with Duleep Trophy around with the pink ball, they haven't yet managed to get the ball right.
Did it?
With all the dew or moisture, it seems to soften up very quickly. Now, if that happens in Test cricket, would you then still enjoy watching it?
No, Cyrus, the main point is that some of the players who played in the Duleep Trophy, like for example, Dinesh Karthik's come out in the media and said that they obviously didn't feel too comfortable playing with it. And the other thing is, the batsman still needs to see the ball in the light. So that's one. The second part in India is the whole SG Kookaburra ball issue. I mean, they've never played with this ball before, and a lot of times batsmen weren't able to see it properly under the lights.
I mean, that's a bit silly actually. Unless the lights were bad. I mean, world over they're playing Test cricket with it. If you can't see the ball, that argument holds no.
Did it work in Australia?
Well, they say it worked, but who says it worked? Like I've spoken to a few players and say as soon as the lights come on and there's a guy, it changes completely. The ball starts swinging around and I don't know what the...
Yeah, but the problem in India is a good or bad?
Well, the players, I don't think the players that I've spoken to were a big fan of it, no.
I wonder if BCCI has actually gone and spoken to the guys who played Duleep Trophy. What do you all think?
They don't know who they are.
Yeah, well...
This is like India, the India,
you're right,
A, India B, India
you're right.
A2.
You're right. It wasn't supposed to happen, then it happened, Duleep Trophy. So, they probably would be the right guys to give you feedback whether it's, you know, whether it's worth trying out to playing in India. I think we get a lot of dew during winters. And then the ball, I'm still not convinced.
Asking a lay question, if we play white ball cricket under lights at the same time of year, is it what, the white ball, is it just about harder?
Still gets wet and soggy.
But you change
but
the
you're
ball.
Playing a 50-over game or a 20-over game. But here you're talking about test cricket.
You're effectively playing the same number of
balls. But you're going to play with the same ball the next day.
Yeah. Can you prepare pitches differently? Given
well, that's
the
what I think they did in Adelaide.
They did that in Australia. Yeah. They did in Adelaide, yeah. They did for sure. They prepared.
But can India do that?
Also, India are a little late generally. They were late to accept T20.
India is never late. It's a deliberate thing.
Late to accept DRS. Now again, pink ball, they'll probably be the last
but like, everybody, I think everybody said, what about the business point of view, having the night cricket or people...
No, but then it should
in
be in bigger
six.
Cities. I think smaller cities where the stadiums are away from the ground, it's difficult to get people there anyway.
But that's what you're looking is that...
Maybe try.
No, so we're coming back to the point where Sri Lanka is struggling to get crowds. Let's, with due respect to them, the present Sri Lankan team in India,
I have an
should
idea.
We have had an evening session?
I think that test cricket should go in completely the opposite direction, like Norwegian slow TV. Like the USP of test cricket should be that it's long.
Norwegian slow TV because we don't have so much time as you have to know all these facts.
Norwegian slow TV is this television program where, for example, for 18 hours you just watch a train just moving along the countryside.
Iran TV.
Justin, you need to go to the gym.
India,
take an hour out. What you need to try out, whatever the cost, whether the ball is soapy or not. Just try out and see if it at least brings people. Because major stadiums, major venues, no one's interested in Test cricket in India.
It's worth trying, but you know, if it works, it'll be great for India because there will be, like I said, more crowds come in than they do during the day.
I would go. If the match is on at 6 o'clock, I would go.
You know, Test cricket
time with only the for the first one or all evening games?
I would go West Indies are playing. I don't go for
this current West Indies also you'll watch.
I'll go for Australia. Chalo. Sean's a good mate. Australia.